The Commission on Human Rights is also investigating the alleged rescue of indigenous students in Cebu City. Joining us now is the Chief Investigator of the CHR's Region 7 Office, Mr. Leo Villarino. Good morning, sir, and thank you for joining us on the program.
Good morning, Christian. Good morning.
So you've started the investigation. Can you tell us whether you have determined already whether what happened was a raid or a rescue?
It's too premature, actually, Christian, to make any conclusions that it was a raid or it was a rescue. No? That is why our investigation is ongoing. But generally, if we have to base the our perception of what happened in the incident, if you will only be basing that on the videos that would be seen on social media or TV, I would say, as far as our perspective is concerned, I would say that there was a chaotic environment that took place during that so-called rescue, which should not have happened, no? If it was carefully and well planned. But then again, whether it was actually a raid or a rescue, that we need to place on record in our investigation report, that which we will be submitting in a few days. But we still have to terminate. We still have to continue with our investigation and wind it up after we feel it that it's already complete. But there are still many things to cover in our investigation. We started our investigation in the afternoon of Monday. Yesterday, we deployed our investigators and we gathered much information yesterday because we were able to talk with the parents of the Lumad children. And in the afternoon of Monday, when we started our initial investigation, we were able also to talk to some of the children.
Okay. Based on those conversations, were you able to establish whether those children were being held, or minors were being held against their will?
Actually, there was none. Except for one who was very hysterical. Probably she was the one who was heard in the video screaming during the alleged rescue. Most of the children, in fact, they are scheduled to leave this Sunday if their papers will already be completed. They are supposed to leave with their parents, with the six parents, this Sunday. And all of them manifested, told our investigators who interviewed them that they will be going with their parents on back to their places, to their hometown.
Okay, they were willing to join their parents or rejoin their parents. My question
that
was...
what we have gathered.
Okay, just to clarify this question, did any of the minors you spoke with say that they were being held against their will in that so-called Lumad school? By their teachers, by the elders?
In fact, the children says that they came because of this prior agreement with these so-called teachers. Now, so when they were brought to Cebu, they were also cooperating and wanted to stay in these places.
Okay, so did they tell you why they were there in the first place? Well, why they decided to join?
Oh, they said that they were just continuing where they're participating in this backward school program.
Okay. Were you also established whether they were kidnapped?
You know, the term kidnap is a conclusion. In fact, it is now an allegation by the police. Because, again, according to the police, these children were taken without the consent of their parents and were not returned as agreed upon. So, as a matter of an allegation, it is the burden now of the police actually to provide evidence that kidnapping actually took place. It would be unfair for the arrested persons to say that they were kidnapped. It is actually the burden of proving the allegations of kidnapping should now belong to the police and provide evidence.
But based on what you know so far, do you think there was kidnapping involved?
If based on what we have what we have gathered from the interviews with the student, with these children, there was no force or intimidation that they were taken against their will, an element of kidnapping.
Was there indoctrination?
Well, if I have to base my statement now on the pronouncement of the social worker that is in charge of these Lumad children, the social worker says that there was no indoctrination.
Were they being recruited to join the communist movement or anything that was related even remotely to the communist movement?
None was said of that. Okay. No children said of that.
And talking of other things that you were able to establish so far, when you spoke with the parents, I think six of them, according to police, had gone to
yesterday.
The police to seek their help, right? Were able to validate that. That was a version of the police. That they conducted
they
the rescue, quote-unquote, because supposedly six of the parents came to them and sought their help. You're able to validate that.
That is correct, yes. We were able to validate that with the parents in our interview yesterday with them.
Okay. And according to the police also, many, if not all of the minors that were quote-unquote rescued had not been in touch or had been away from their parents for about 2 years. Was that true?
That is correct.
Now, why was that the case, based on your conversations with the parents and the children?
Well, that is one question that we have been asking the parents, why it took them 2 years to finally seek the whereabouts of their children. But all they explained was that it took them time, especially that they're living in a very remote area, until finally they had to seek the help of the authorities. First, they went to their tribal leader who seek audience with the mayor of their town to finally ask help for the to locate the whereabouts of their children.
Mm. But based on your interviews with the children, with the minors and the parents, how were the children brought to the company of the elders who were with them in that school in Cebu City?
They were with some elders. One person who we actually identified, but we will not name him today, brought him first to Davao, and then eventually here in Cebu. No? They were transferred from one area to another, and that is what also we want to find out. In fact, I have tasked our investigators to fill in these locations to locate where actually these are, because the children, when they were asked, they were not aware. They do not know what are these places, because they are not familiar with these places. So that is one task that we have to do, is to identify and locate where are these places that these children are referring to.
Okay. Now, so far, were you able to establish anything illegal in that entire affair?
Well, if you say that is illegal it would be illegal for a person not to return the children upon demand of the parents, that would be illegal. Mm. But there is a lot of explaining that has to be done, because now, in fact, the university that has accommodated the children in their retreat house explained that they were in fact preparing for the return of the children, but they were just prevented because of this COVID lockdown here in Cebu.
Okay, and of course we need to put this in context, that the ongoing investigation by the CHR is not in anything remotely related to any criminal investigation, right? So
yes.
Your focus here is of course human rights. Let's try to elaborate on that para maintindihan ng viewers natin. Baka akala this is a criminal investigation. No, this is not.
Yes, in fact, we just want to point out, no, we are not looking into the political ideology or beliefs of these children or those who were arrested. No, it is personal to them. What the Commission on Human Rights is actually investigating is whether or not during this alleged rescue or the alleged or the arrest or their stay in this retreat house, violations of human rights were committed against the children and those who also were arrested during this raid.
Okay, and so far, what have you found out or established regarding that in that respect?
I'd rather not say this person, pardon me, I apologize, but this has to be first validated and then we have to place this in our report.
Okay, so your focus is to determine whether the rights of the children of the minors or the human rights of the minors had been violated. That is the focus, right?
Yes. In fact, that would also include the retreat house that has been accommodating them.
Mm-hmm. And how soon are you expected to complete the investigation?
Hopefully, we can finish this because the children and the parents will be leaving by Sunday. Hopefully, by next week, we can already wind up with our investigation.
Okay. By the way, for the record, how many minors are involved here?
There are 19.
19 minors. How young?
Yes.
How old is the youngest?
14, and the eldest would be around 17 years old.
So all of them are expected to return home by Sunday. Is that correct?
That is what we have gathered yesterday from our talks with the parents.
And so far, how's the accommodation? Where are they staying?
Well, we have asked. In fact, we have asked the parents because they are staying also with their children. They are now living together, no? The six parents and the children, because most of the children also are related to one another, no? They are well accommodated. They do not have any complaint. As far as also as the persons arrested, we also found out yesterday that they were treated. There was no complaint of any form of torture or harassment. So they're all fine.
Okay. Now, will your recommendations also cover the bigger picture, which is, of course, the plight of the Lumads, of the indigenous peoples in certain areas in the Philippines, in particular in the south, for instance, who are actually caught in the middle of this conflict between the communist rebels and, of course, the national government, the state forces?
That is no longer within my jurisdiction, Christian. I cannot touch whatever happened to the other areas, but definitely we'll only be concentrating what happened in this incident that is being looked into now by the commission.
Yeah, yeah. Of course, in this particular case, I mean, will there also be recommendations, for example? Will that particular big picture also be touched on, but specific to what happened here, to this group of minors?
Definitely, definitely. Because not only that we are conducting an investigation for the purpose of availing of legal remedies that can be available to them, like, for example, the filing of criminal or administrative charges to those who will be responsible, but also the investigation will also be the basis for any policy that will be recommended to Congress or to whatever government office that should have attended to this incident.
Yeah, good thing that you pointed that out, because whether even if this is not a criminal investigation, the findings could be helpful in case of any legal proceedings
definitely.
That might happen in the future and policy decisions by the government. Okay.
In fact, that is one of the powers of the commission in its investigative power. The findings in this investigation would be the basis for policy recommendations to our government.
Okay. And by the way, were you able to determine what did they tell you regarding the fact that they were brought to Davao, back to Davao, and not to the DSWD in Cebu?
Come again, Christian?
Yeah, because the minors are brought to Davao, right? DSWD in Davao.
That was the first location.
Why were they not brought in the DSWD branch or office in Cebu?
That is what also we're trying to find out.
Is that a matter of jurisdiction?
I would not say, but that is a matter that has to be looked into.
Okay. Mr. Leo Villarino, thank you for joining us, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. And good morning, Christian.
Good morning, sir.